right, this is a black wire right here. We're going to unsolder that. That's actually the ground. Let's see if I can get that in there. It may be easier for me to cut it. There we go. So now we've taken the old, pretty much the old regulator apart. This lead in here is the minus 36, and this lead in here is the plus 36. These leads will have to be fixed in this particular instance because they're frayed. And this is the ground, and these are the two speaker leads. So those are the only things you'll have left on this board, and that's it. And only because they're going to these two connectors for your amp modules. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to take this unit here. You'll see there's two sets of wires. One is 6 inches long, and the other one is almost a foot long, or about a foot long. What you want to do is, since you removed the ones that were... that's your earphone jack. What you want to do is try to feed them through the grommet if you could, or any other available hole, as long as they don't short out. So, but we'll try feeding it through a grommet. There's your black lead. And we're pulling it through. So there's your black lead, and there's your red lead. I'd like to point out that your chassis might be slightly different than this one that we're filming. But in the end result, is they're pretty much the same when you put the unit in. See, we've pulled the red and the black, and those are the foot-long ones. All right, and then here are the two which are real short. They're only 6 inches. And what we're going to do with the 6-inch ones is the black lead is going to go to pin 4 on this connector. If you're not sure which is pin 4, double check and use a bright light. The numbers are written on the side of the connector, but the black wire is pin 4. That's pin 4 right there. And they're going to take the green wire, the short green wire, and we're going to attach it to pin 1, which is out here. If you're changing the connector, you'll find it easier to wire the connector before you pop rivet it back in. Okay, so now we've got this wired in, let's wire the other two leads in. Alright, so in this particular instance, this is the black wire, and it goes to the chassis ground, which is right here. See this right, this yellow and red striped wire? That's your ground for the center tap between the two. It also goes to one of the capacitors. You see this? I'll try to get that at the right angle. And you can do it here or you can do it here. It doesn't really matter. We'll see if we can do it here. If I can heat it up. There we go. I think we're slowly getting it. Alright, as you can see, we've replaced that bare wire, which is probably going to be bare on your chassis, with an insulated wire. This is the wire from the regulator assembly, which is the 12-inch long black. And this is the wire from the transformer, which is the yellow striped red. And now we're going to hook up, that's the ground. And now we're going to hook up the other side, which is the... the positive side, which is going to be hooked up to the bridge rectifier. And it normally would be hooked up to this red wire right here, which broke off. we're going to resolder it back. And it goes right here. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to sit there and heat up the connection for the bridge rectifier.
What side of the
That's the rectifier? Positive side of the bridge rectifier. Positive side.
And how do you tell that by looking
well,
at it?
Well, you know, the on the diode there's a little band that's on one side of the diode, and this is the side where the two bands face each other.
Okay.
And that's how you'll find it. Now, whatever you do, don't put this on the wrong side because you won't pass the smoke test. And then the other one comes in. All right, so we've got the leads in here. We're going to solder them. This is on the positive side.
Yeah, that's fine.
All right, and that takes into the 12-inch red, and this is the red going to the positive side of the capacitor for the plus 36 volts. Having said that, and like I said, we will have to redo these because these are about ready to fall off. Those are the plus and minus 36 volts. But in any case, the rest of the unit is sitting here like this. And what we're going to do is we're going to take this new 24-volt regulator, rather. We're going to apply some heatsink paste. Look. Alrighty. By the way, the heatsink paste is poisonous, and if you do get it on you, you should obviously wash it off after use before doing anything like eating. So there's the heatsink paste. Now, the heatsink paste isn't absolutely positively 100% required. You can get away with it without it if you don't have it. But I recommend that you do, to use it. All right, so now we've done that. And you see this screw over here in the corner? It's attaching the faceplate, so we're going to mount that there. And we're going to take the screw, we're going to loosen it, take the nut off, and this is sitting here like this. You'll find that fits over it. I'm going to have to get... I don't think you'll be able to see me put the nut on.
Yeah, no, they can go. We've already paid them.
There we go.
Credit card.
All we'll have to do is...
Well, I can pay you to have to pack it up, and I can find out how much it's going to be. I was thinking about UPS supply chain. Are you familiar